Once again, hello everyone, and thank you for joining the webinar, What's New in Dynamics 365 Business Central Version 18. I'm very happy to present today's topic as the new version of Business Central was launched just a week before. And today, Stefano De Miliani, Microsoft MVP, author of many successful IT books, will share with us fresh insights on the new version. My name is Ieva, and today I will be a moderator of a webinar. So if there will be any questions or technical issues, just drop a message on the chat and I will try to help you. I think that most of you already know Simplanova, but for all who haven't worked with us before, just shortly about our company. Our main area of expertise is upgrades, and we started 8 years ago with classic to RTC upgrades, and now we are working on transition to extensions. We offer not only upgrade and development services for Dynamics 365 Business Central, but also automated tools for upgrade to extensions. In 2017, we have launched our automated tools for classic upgrades, and now our product team is working on a bundle of tools for automating the transition to extensions. As the new version of Business Central is launched, and if you or your customers are interested in upgrading to the latest version, Simplanova offers really simple way to scope and upgrade your Business Central solution. How it works? It works really very simply. We just need to receive the FOB file, and in 5 business days, you will receive free evaluation and analysis of your solution. Why Simplanova, you may ask? So shortly, report upgrades at Simplanova are 95% faster. You will receive upgrade evaluation totally free, and of course also the extensions analysis, which will lead to smoother upgrade to the latest version of the C, and also up to 3 months warranty after the upgrade, also for free. Getting back to today's topic, I would like to ask you to write all the relevant questions in the Q&A, and at the end, together with Stefano, we will try to answer all of these questions. Also, as always, we will share the webinar recording and presentation slides with you by email tomorrow. And now, I would like to invite Stefano to continue with the main today's topic.
Thanks, Ieva. I will share my screen and we can start our presentation. Can you confirm that the screen is shared?
Yes, we see Stefano, your screen. Okay, everything great. Is great.
Okay. So, we in this 1 hour we try to present the news that the new version of Business Central 2021 V1 will be just released in the last week. Please remember that we have a brief overview of all the features available in this new version, but we cannot go too much in details on everything. So we cover everything, but in the time that we have at disposition. Here are my contacts if you need a follow-up or if you need more information about these topics. We have divided the topics into 3 main categories. So we will talk about what's new for the administration part, what's new for the application parts, and what's new for the developer parts. And we will leave the Q&A at the end of the presentation. So we can start with the administration. Business Central version 18, I will use this terminology, starts by introducing a lot of news also from the administration part, so for system administrator. The first news is that, not documented, but you can now run Business Central on anything. So running on everything means that you can now run Business Central 18 on in production environment with anything supported operating system. So also on Docker, also on Windows Server Core. The only limitation is that you need to ensure database compatibility level. So Business Central now supports also availability in production in Docker and on Windows Server Core. In the administration parts, one of the news is that if you have a customer in the cloud with a large database and with lots of companies, you know that with the administration portal, you can export a database, and exporting a database sometimes is a lot of is a time-consuming operations. And in the past, there was problems on big customers due to timeout or insufficient resources allocated into the Azure cloud, into the Azure engine. And with the version 18 release, this engine that handled the export of database is changed. So a new, more reliable solution for database export is providing, and you can now export much larger database without timeouts and so on. So the exported database is absolutely improved. Another important aspect or new aspects of the administration parts is related to delegated admins. I think delegated admins is the way to work with the customer. It's the recommended way, in my opinion, to work with when you have a customer in the cloud. With the delegated admin, you can perform actions in the customer's tenant without using consuming a license in the allowances of the customers, and by using your corporate accounts. And in the past, delegated admins have some limitation, especially related to job queues or executing some tasks into the customer tenant. Now with version 18, delegated admins has more power. So with the delegated admin, now you can pose a job queue. Post a job queue that was scheduled by a user. Previously, you cannot do that. You can now restart a failed job scheduled by an end user. Previously, you cannot do that. You can also execute job queue task, and you can also change the Business Central user experience from essential to premium, for example, or by going to the company information page. Previously, these are all tasks that you cannot do with delegated admins because are mainly task related to the customer. Another important limitation that in the past was a source of different problems, I see many parts with problems on this, was related to Azure Active Directory delegation. So one of the problems in the past was if you was set as delegated admin of your customer and your customer, for example, adds you as a guest into his Azure AAD tenant, for example, because he invites you to collaborate via Teams. These invitations add you as a guest into the customer tenant. And if done that in the past, your delegated admins doesn't work. Now with this release, a partner that has a delegated admin relationship with the customers will keep the same access to Business Central, even if it will be added as a B2B guest. So even if, for example, you have added to a Teams tenant of your customer and so on. So this solves one of the noise problems that delegated admins has in the past. Another interesting new features available in the automation, in the administration part, is related to automation APIs. Now with automation APIs, you can also schedule the installation of per tenant extension on your customer tenant. And when you schedule that, you can also choose between three options, as exactly like you do manually. So you can select the current version of next major or next minor. This is an important new feature related for automating installation of extensions. And this can be done by executing automation API, so in three steps mainly. The first is to insert the extension upload, so by calling the extension upload automation API and by passing the type of version of Business Center that you want to schedule the installation of the extension, current version, next major, next minor. Then you need to upload the extension file, and this can be done by sending a patch request to this URL that you can see here, bypassing the extension file that you want to upload on the tenant. And then you can simply execute the installation of the extension by sending a post request to the Microsoft.NAT.upload action. And in this way, you can automate three step, easy steps that you can execute, for example, via PowerShell or via your scripts. And you can automate the installation of per tenant extensions. You can also, in this release, install AppSource apps using Admin Center APIs. So also you can also, from the Admin Center APIs, check for AppSource apps, check for available updates, and update an app directly without going to the Admin Center and directly or remotely executing this action. So you can have a list of apps by calling the apps endpoint, a list of available updates by calling the available updates endpoint, and then you can, by using an app ID, you can, as in this case, you can pass in the app ID slash update, and with a post request, you can force the update of an app from AppSource. So all it can be automated now in version 18 of Business Center. Another important aspects, new aspect of the administration part is that related to reassigning environment from one Azure AD to another. There are some customers that has raised support tickets to Microsoft related to that. And previously this cannot be done easily. Now you can, for example, if your customer change business or if your customer acquire a new Business Central environments in another Azure AD, maybe your customer wants to preserve its current tenant and move this current tenant to another Azure AD organizations. Now you can do that by raising a support ticket to Microsoft, and Microsoft has you need to provide a proof that you are a delegated admin of both tenants, Source and Dest. And then when this is proved, Microsoft can move your tenant from one Azure AD to another Azure AD easily. So this is supported obviously by raising a request to Microsoft. Previously, this cannot be done. So in administration part, there are a lot of users and mainly related to automation and experience of the SaaS tenant. Now, we can move to the application part. The application part has a lot of news, lots of new features related to application. The first, I think, that is that Business Central now is available on more countries. So there are more countries supported, like Greece, India, Romania, and Turkey. And there are a set of indirect localizations supported via partners. Another news related to the global environment is that now, when you send Business Central to your customer, you can select a lot of countries more, but you can also have the possibility to give development features to your customer for free. So application builder and solution developer functionalities are now included for free in the Business Central Essential and Premium licenses. So also your customer have the rights to develop applications. Business Central version 18 has worked a lot on improving performance of the client side. So there are continuously working on that in order to have a more reliable experience, especially in the cloud. And now Business Central 18 or role centers loads the different parts of role center in a different day compared to the past. So when you open Business Central role center into your browser, parts are loaded one by one, starting from the top. So the first part that you are visible is immediately loaded, and the parts that are not visible are not immediately loaded. This can improve the experience and performances of the responsibilities of the client. And when you scroll them down, the other parts are loaded only when you have scrolled. So the total time to load the role center is reduced, and the content is the experience is much more quicker than in the past. Remember that with Business Central 18, there's no more support for Internet Explorer. And Business Central 18 is optimized for the new Edge. So Edge is the browser that officially can give you the more more features and more performance with Business Central, because the web client is all optimized for the new Edge. Business Central 18 adds also a thing that I think that is one of the new thing that immediately takes to your eyes. And it's related to the new company setup wizard. When you start a new company, you have a wizard that permits you to follow up immediately the creation of a new company. And now you have also some visual aids that permits you to know what you are doing, having an immediate quick help on what page you are, or what actions you are doing. And this is for helping your customer to self-learn features and to know how to use the product. And these visual aids are default in the database applications, but you can also create your own visual aids, and we'll see that in the developer part. And you can also customize existing visual aids. So all these visual aids are displayed the first time that you open a particular page, or the first time that you open a particular action, and are helpful to improve the experience and the help of your customer experience. Other new features related to the application and functional parts is the assisted setup for adjusting item cost in the background. Now, when you go to the inventory setup, you have a flag called automatic posting, automatic cost posting. If you disable this flag, or if you set automatic cost adjustment to never, automatically an assisted setup guide becomes available to you. And this permits you to configure the item cost adjustment process in background by using the job queue. So if you set this as off, for example, you have an automatic pop-up that shows you that you can schedule a job queue entry. And if you click this, you have a wizard that permits you to set up the schedule the cost adjustment and posting directly by using job queue in the background without doing nothing. So totally automated. Another important features is related to the automatic creation of lot and serial number informations. There are a lot of customers that requires that in the past. So not only tracking the lot number, but also or the serial numbers, but also to have additional information related to a lot on the serial number. So like a card of information related to a lot. And now Business Central supports that by offering the lot no information and serial number information pages. And to support that, you need to go to your item tracking code page, and there's a flag that you need to turn on that is the create serial number inform posting or create lot number inform posting. These are the flags that must be enabled in order to support them. And when you go into the item tracking lines, you can also, you have now available also two new actions that permit you to check the serial number information card or the lot number information card, and then end of them. And so for each item tracking line, And then you can also, if you, for example, are you are on the item tracking lines and you want to create numbers, serial numbers in bulk, you can now call the create customized SN actions. And these actions, or the assigned serial number actions, depends on what you want. And this action starts the create SN information or reports that permits you to choose if for each serial numbers or lot that this action creates, if automatically must be created also the card, so also the serial number information card. This is extremely important if you handle business, for example, that tracks a lot of information related to a lot and not simply a number. And other interesting features are related to the bank reconciliations. Bank reconciliation is normally a financial and accounting task that must be, it's quite critical because you need to ensure that everything is registered and cash are positioned correctly. And now Business Central helps a lot on this. Because in the bank, one of the features is that from the bank accounts reconciliation page, you can now cancel a bank reconciliation. That may be your previously posted with errors. And then from the bank statements, you can run a new bank reconciliations. You can also change the statement number for a bank reconciliation. That maybe you have you want to redo. And simply by calling on the bank account reconciliation page, they change statement number actions. So a lot of actions in order to redo bank reconciliation and fix errors. You can also now, one of the interesting features on related to this topic is that previously importing a bank statement file was not so easy because sometimes you should create custom imports and so on. Now you can directly configure the import of flat file or comma or separated file, CSV file, directly from the user interface. If you check Business Central now on the extension management page, you have an extension installed called Simplifying Bank Statement Import. And with this extension, if you go to the a new page called Bank Export Import Setup, you have a new action called Bank Statement File Format Wizard. And if you select a bank export, and if you click Bank Statement File Format Wizard, a wizard starts. And this wizard permits you to define the format of the file that you are importing, the fields, what fields in the file you have, what fields you need to map on your Business Central and so on. And when you have created this template, in the bank account card, automatically the bank statement input format is created. And so each time you import that type of bank statement, a particular import file is import file format is called. So easy way to import the bank files now. Another new feature is related to BIN codes. BIN codes are now added also to jobs. As default, these are not visible fields. So you, in order to see that, you need to customize that pages and extract, make it them visible. So location code and BIN code, for example, on job planning are not, or job journal line are not default as default visible, but you can make it that visible. And now that this permits you to, when you create a job planning line or a job journal line, you can now specify also the item number and the location code and the BIN code. The BIN code is automatically suggested by the item, when you select the item. You can also choose the BIN by using the lookup into the BIN code. And this lookup opens the BIN content page. So you have the BIN content page where you can see all the BINs with the details. And all this is supported by the entire job flow. So you can also support completely using beans in your jobs, your entire job flows. Please remember that if you open that page as default, these fields are not immediately visible. So you need to make them visible through personalizations. Another new features is related to the contact and customer card or vendor, is specular. Now, if you open the customer card and you go to the address and contact tab, you can see that the contact relations, the field the contact code or contact name contains now the default contact of type person for this specific customer. Not they are not linked to the contact or type company in the contact table. And the address and contact fields that you have here are now related to the customer and not are related to the contact. So these are the contact of the main customer, and this is the main contact of this customer. So a contact type person. If you want to register a connection between a customer or vendor and a contact type company, now you should use the link to existing action from the contact card in order to link this contact to your customer or vendor. So this is the main difference now in Business Central IT, conceptual and practical difference related to contacts into the card. So remember that this is the contact type person related to customers. Another new feature is related to lot sizes on productions. Sorry for this bad quality image. But now you have the ability to specify lot sizes directly also in production. So for example, in production order routing, planning routing, routing version and so on, you have also available a lot size field where you can specify the lot size. And this is then handled in all the entire process. This field is exactly like the beans code into the jobs process. So it's either by default, and you can add it by personalizing the page, but it's then completely supporting into the process. Another interesting feature is related to dimension corrections in GL entries. Now in the general ledger entry page, you have a new action called correct dimensions that permits you to correct dimensions on your posted entries. And you can simply click it and edit the dimension value or add a new value, remove values and so on. And administrators can also lock dimensions for corrections if you don't want, for example, permits the modification of the correction must respect, for example, period or when or closed accounting and so on. So in this, with this new feature in the general ledger entry page, you have these new actions, correct dimension and history of dimension corrections. If you click on correct dimensions, a new page opens where you can see the dimension of this entry, and you can fix, so change dimensions, add new dimensions, delete dimensions, and so on. And then you can, when you are done, you can click on the execute actions, and this saves the modifications. When you click the execute actions, you can choose. Normally, changing the dimension is could be a time-consuming process. So you can select to run it immediately, or you can schedule that in a later time. If it's like running immediately, it will be executed immediately, otherwise no. Then you have also the possibilities to check when you have done the correction. You have the possibility to check the history of your dimension corrections. And then this means that you can see a complete list of the correction that you have done into a particular entry, who has done and what you have done. And then you can also, the interesting part is that you can also edit a particular corrections. So for example, I want to edit this correction, I click on edit. You can re-edit the corrections. You can see that you have changed some dimensions on this value and so on. And you can, for example, undo, change that or undo or copy to draft, means that you can copy it as a draft using another validations. So quite easy and quite powerful in order to change the dimension into registered entries. Another new aspect is related to the contact list. Contact list is and the contact page is revisited. If you see the contact list in the brick view, it shows a lot more information. So it shows information like the type of the contact, if it's a customer or a vendor or a company. And it gives you immediately the main contact information directly immediately visible. If you open the contact card now shows you the business relations. So if you click the business relation, you can directly connect to the customer or vendor card or the employee card. So these are the main changes related to the page. Also for related to the previously explained the modifications. And the contact card also has another interesting features is related to the indirection log entries. You can also have this use fast tab in order to track all the complete history of the interactions that your company has done with this contact. So if you have sent some orders, some quotes, and so on, opportunities, all is tracked here. And it's quite like an easy CRM system. Directly in the contact, you can have all the complete track of what you have. Another new feature is related to inventory documents for inventory adjustments. This is, in my opinion, one of the most interesting part in the application part, because now you can also have two new documents, two new type of documents that you can use for making inventory adjustment. One is the inventory receipt and one is the inventory shipment document. These documents are mainly documents for doing inventory adjustment. So inventory receipt document is a document that permits you to register an increase of your inventory. And inventory shipment is a document that permits you to register a decrease of your inventory. So for example, that you can use for missing or damaged goods or something like that. These are documents, full documents. So the full documents means that for example, for the inventory receipt, you have a card with header lines. And to create an inventory receipt document, you can simply go to the inventory receipt page and then you can fill the header and the line, place the item in the line with the quantity, and then register, you post the document, and a increase of that quantity you have placed here is created into your inventory. The opposite is the inventory shipment document. So when the inventory shipment is exactly the same, but you can create an header, a line, register a quantity, and this quantity is decreased from your inventory. As said, these are documents, so these are not only like a batch, but are full documents. So this means that you can go into the post and invoice receipts and post and invoice shipments, and you can call these documents, reprint these documents, for example, so you have something like a document to print for your usage. And you can also specify which reports must be printed at the different stages. So in the report selection page, now you have also these type of documents that you can handle for inventory receipt, inventory shipped, post inventory receipt, and post inventory shipment. So you can have four different type of records and use if you want to also print these documents. These documents are totally tracked. So if you go into the item ledger entries that you have posted from these documents, you can see that if I register an inventory receipt, I have a positive adjustment for this item or of a particular quantity with the reference to this document number. You can also navigate, so find entries to relate to these documents. And when you navigate these, you can, the navigations returns you that you have from a particular item ledger entry. For example, if I navigate, one of the new results of navigation that you have also the item receipt header, for example, or item shipment header. And for this, you can open the item receipt document, for example. So it totally is tracked into the system. So these are two new documents that permit you and to handle inventory modifications quite good and totally tracked. Another new features is related to availability by lot. Now on the item card or list or on all incoming and outgoing documents, you can directly see the list of lots. So availability for lots. So this means that you can have the quantity on your inventory plus the expected incoming and outgoing transactions. So sales, purchase, and so on. So if you click on these features, you can have a page that shows you the availability for each lot. And if you enable lot specific tracking for an item, you can also get an overview of the quantities by this specific tracking number by opening from the item tracking page, the availability by lot page, and you can see the details. So this is much more improved into this new release. All the lot tracking and bin tracking is more improved in this new Business Central release. Another new feature related to dimensions. Dimensions, previously we have seen that you can correct dimension of posted documents, but now you can also help your user to choose dimension values. So instead of allowing users to just go into the list of the dimension value and then pick up values, when you have dimension with value posted set to code mandatory, you have now a new field called allow values filter, where you can predefine a list of allowed dimension values that your users can choose. So for example, if I have this dimension called area, I set it as value posted is called mandatory. This means that it's, my user must have a value. This dimension must have a value. And you can also, you have also this field, allow a values filter, where you can specify what dimension can be chosen for this. And this can, if you click on the assist edit, you have a page where you can select the dimension values that you want to use. And these dimensions are the dimensions that are inserted into the allowed values filter. And this permits you to have a control of what type of dimension you can choose in when you do a registrations. Another new feature is related to variant code support in production order. In production order now, you can also specify a variant code. So not only the item, but also the variant. So a new variant code field is added to the production order header, as you can see here. And you can specify the variant of the article to produce. And these fields are not visible as default. So you need to, if you want to use them, you need to put them visible by personalization. And you have the variant code field is the production order page. And on the stock keeping unit page, you can also add the production bond and production routing fields. And these fields can be filled you can specify what type of production bond and production royalty use on the stockkeeping unit page. And if you you don't specify nothing, these fields are the values are used in the retrieved from the item card as default. So now in production order supports also variants. Another new features related to the new feature management of our prices is related to the possibility to editing prices when active. So when we have a price list now, you can edit prices only if you go into the price list and put it as open and edit pages, edit the new fields, and then retake them as released. And now if you go onto the sales and receivables setup and you set the allow editing active price field as true, on the sales and receivable at specular is for the purchase and payables, you can edit prices even if the item, the price list is active. This means that you can go into the price list lines page, the new page available in the new feature. You can edit a new price, for example, for type and so on, for a particular type or a particular item. And you can also click on verify lines in order to have a check that permits you to avoid duplicate prices or inconsistency between prices. And you can also verify, modify prices by, this is a feature that permits you to control if the price that you have inserted here, edited here, is not in conflict with our with other price list or for dates and so on. And when this flag into the setup, the allow editing prices flag into the setup is turned off, obviously if you want to update prices, you must change, as in the past, the status of the price list to draft. So if it's on, you can directly change the field, the price into the an active price list line now, and you can also verify. If it's off, it's like, exactly like in the past. Remember, as I've written in the note here, this feature is only available if you enable the feature update, the new sales pricing experience in the feature management page. Otherwise, it's actually not enabled. There are then various other improvements that I've leave it here. For example, payment reconciliation journals now supports application against employee ledger entries. You can now select multiple lines to transfer to another journals. You can configure the import of flat file for bank statement. You can also use WarMail merge capabilities in order to send documents to customer contacts and so on. You can activate additional dimension in item tracking by enabling these features. So use tracking by package number is a reservation and tracking system. And this permits you to use item tracking and package number on different tables. There are a lot of improvements also related to connected applications. Connected application means that Teams and the Power Platform integrations. For Teams, remember that Business Center 18, now the Teams application is officially released, so it's not in public review, but now is generally available. From Teams now you can pass every link from every entity in Business Central, and now you have you can see details directly on Teams. The experience is improved compared to the past, so now cards opens more quickly. You can have details and you can click and go to Business Central and so on. Now you can also look up Business Central contacts from Teams directly from the search box or from the message and look at if you have the Teams app, a contact that you have in Business Center can be referenced on Teams. You can view contact information and historical data in Teams. If you have Power BI, if you are using Power BI reports, you can connect to Business Central. Now also with by calling Business Central APIs, custom APIs and standard APIs, and not only by using Page, Esposi and Web Services. This is extremely important. We will talk about that about later. And for Dataverse, there are support for virtual tables now. Virtual tables are the possibility to share entities between Business Central and Dataverse for integrations without duplication of data. Virtual tables now supports CRUD operation, and with Business Central also we have relations. If you are interested in this topic, we have some webcasts planned in the upcoming days. The Microsoft Teams app, as said before, is now generally available. The Teams app is also optimized for mobile. So for iOS, Android, and so on, you can, it's totally adaptable. You can see it, it can be adapted to the screen of your device. You can view card details, every card details directly from the mobile app of Teams, the Teams mobile app. And then if you click on a details, for example, you can directly open into your device, the Business Central app, mobile app. And the Business Central mobile app is immediately open directly into the details that you are showing. Business Central for Teams now supports also printing reports to cloud-enabled printers, and supports also the access to device camera and location, things that previously are not available. Related to printing, there are some news. I think that you know that printing in the cloud is quite a problem. Now, there's a Business Center supports what is called Universal Print. Universal Print is a service offered by Microsoft, cloud print service available on Azure. And available on it runs on Azure data centers, and it's available on all users and customers that have a valid subscription of Windows or Microsoft 365. These are the listed of all the available subscriptions. And from Business Central 18, you can Universal Printing is automatically supported. So you can directly print by using this service, and simply you can click, you know, on the Universal Print Setup Wizard into your Business Center, and then set up your connection to your Universal Printer. Remember that this service is not free. So Universal Print is an Azure service available across applications, and it has a cost. It comes normally with a pool of print jobs available to all users, so all licensed users. Normally, you have 5 print jobs per month for users. And users' print jobs are expires at the end of each month. And you can also buy print jobs according to your user. So it's a service that has a cost, and you should evaluate the users that your users are doing on printing, or that you use to use that. Another new features related to item availability sync with 365 for Sales. If you are using Dynamics 365 for Sales connected to Business Central, now you have an important features that permits you to see directly on CRM on 365 for Sales the availability of item in Business Central. So simply go on Business Central connection setup, Dynamics 365 connection setup, click on the automatically synchronized item availability. And now if this is true, you can enable inventory availability synchronization between Business Central and Dynamics 365 for Sales. So when an inventory change in Business Central, the change is automatically see can be automatically reflected to Dynamics 365 for Sales. This can be done by the wizard or directly by the system. This is the wizard that permits you set up this automatic synchronized item availability. And this is available on also on CRM, on the CRM side. So for example, when the user enters a sales order in 3546, you have a new field called quantity on end that shows the availability on Business Central. And all is synchronized between Business Central and CRM. So this is quite interesting and solves one of the requests in this field that from the past comes from many partners. This covers all the main new features available into the application part. There are a lot of features that obviously we have gone quickly today, but there are a lot of features to explore, I think. Now we see the new features available related to the development part. So mainly related to developers and extension development. One of the new features, hidden feature, not documented, but I think that we have just discovered this, is that in the extension management page, now you can see that finally, the scope of the extension is automatically displayed. You can see it in the new published as field, where you can see the scope of the extension. So for example, global means that the extension comes from AppSource, while PTA is an extension that is a pertinent extension, so an app that comes not from AppSource. But important, in my opinion, is dev. Dev means that this is an extension that is published on this tenant by Visual Studio. Normally, you should never do that. And it's important to remember that, I think that it's important to remember to know how extensions you have on that tenant deployed with Visual Studio, for example, on a sandbox. Now you can do that simply by filtering publish as dev. And you can remember that if you have an extension published as dev during an upgrade on a sandbox, you lose this extension. So you need to republish them again. So you should never use them into your online tenant. So now you have this visible. We have talked at the end about the new user experience. So Business Central now, 18 now has on all pages a quick help that you can permit you to have to give your user a quick help on the page where on the app or on the action where the user is. This can be handled on the pages and controls. Now I have two new properties called about title and about text. These two new properties controls the text and the title of the tip that appears to the user when it goes to that page. And you can set it on the page, groups, parts, fields, and actions. So this means that this is the user experience that you have. So you can have automatically by setting on a page the about title properties and about text properties, a pop-up that show the titles, show the text that you have placed there. And the user can click on take tour and go into each step of the pages. So each controls of the pages and see the help of each control of the pages. To do that, please remember that you need to enable the teaching tips into the My Settings, otherwise the take tour doesn't start. And remember that, for example, a complete page here, if you select take tour, you can see all the informations on this page controls. So it goes from top to bottom of this page definition. And the tour shows you all the informations that you have on that page. So it starts from the page, what is the page, click on next. It goes on each field on the page, click on next, goes to the action. And it's quite a self-explanatory help for your user that you can handle simply by setting, as you can see in this page definition, about title and about text properties from at the page level, at the field level, at the action level and so on, or the group level and so on. And You can also extend standard tools. So for example, you can create a page extension of an existing page, and then you can extend the about title and the about text properties. And this means that when the user opens the posted sales invoice, now you will see this tool, this message. And please remember, because this was on a question raised some time ago from some partners, remember that these properties should are born to help users on discovering what features and what should do on that this particular page, not to outline a complete business process. Because as said before, these tips are displayed in the same page order as the declaration. So starts from the page, then from the groups, from the fields, from the action, and so on. So top to bottom. So you cannot simulate a business process, but it's an help that you can, a guided help that you can provide to your user. Now, there are a lot of IEL improvements. I listed that here, and I will show them later by opening Visual Studio Code. Now, for example, you can add keys from a table extension objects with fields from a base table. Previously, you cannot do that. You can now also obsolete interfaces. So now interfaces supports the obsolescence. Now you can now return complex types from your IEL code. So not only simple types like integer, like decimal text and so on, but also complex types. So for example, you can return customer, you can return objects. You have now the possibility to define entitlements and permissions directly from IEL with three new objects called entitlement, permission set, and permission set extensions. Actually, when you create an extension, you define a permission set by using an XML file that you can provide together with your extension code. And this defines the permission that your extension has. In the future, this will be deprecated in favor of directly creation of the permission set from IEL code. And now both are supported. And now you can define directly in code. So entitlement, permission set, and permission set extension. Entitlements describes which objects in Business Central a customer is entitled to use according to the license that yes. While permission describes objects, which object an administrator or reparter give the use to the customer users. And these objects are quite important, because the idea is that in the future, this will be one of the fundamental blocks of for handling upsource marketing of your extension and upsource selling of your extension. So you can, by using these objects, control what your user can do with your extension. Another requested new features available in Business Central IT is the record extension. So the possibility to extend an existing record. I think that you know that if you want to create a report now, you cannot extend a standard report, but if you want, for example, you want to create, to modify the sales invoice, you need directly duplicate the sales invoice report and then add your custom modifications. Now you have the ability to extend an existing report by creating a report extension objects. And inside this report extension objects, you can make additive changes to the dataset and to the request page. Remember that report layouts will not have an accessibility model. So for report layouts, you need to create your own. But now, for example, if you want only to add a field into the sales invoice, you can simply extend the sales invoice, add your field, and then you inherit all what you have in a standard dataset. And it's quite useful, I think, this. To show some of this feature, I prefer directly to go quickly into Visual Studio Code. So I will open this. Please forget the errors, because these errors here are explicitly created to show things. So very quick list of the features that I previously explained. One is the about title and the about text properties. As you can see, you can extend a page, and you can set these two new properties. And these two new properties are the tooltip, the bullets that appears to your user when it opens this page. For example, the dimension page, when the user opens this dimension page and you have created this page extension, automatically you have a pop-up that shows to your users that the title is dimension, and the description of this pop-up shows what the dimension does, and then your user has a take tour action where he can go and then check the actions and have a complete help. Another features available in Business Central 18, and so in the IL language 7, is related to the possibility to create keys with the standard fields. So for example, in this case, I created a table extension of the item table. I added a new field into the item table. And then I created here into the keys block, I created a key by using a standard field of the item table. Previously, you cannot do that. You cannot create a key with a standard field of a table. Now you can do that. What you cannot do is this. So you cannot create a key that spans between a custom field and a standard field. So this is actually not supported. You can only now create new keys with standard fields, so fields from the base table, but not fields from keys that mix fields. So not keys that mix a standard table, a field, and a custom field. Another feature that we have talked before is the possibility of obsolete interface. So if you have an interface that you want simply you don't want to use anymore, you can select the obsolete state properties exactly like you do in every object now, and you can obsolete the interface object by giving also a reason. Very, very easy definitions. You can now, another new features, interesting features in my opinion, is that now you can return complex types. So for example, you can have a function, like in this case, that returns a customer. And as you can see, this is a procedure. I call it getCustomerByName. It returns a object of type record and subtype customer. And you can do exitCustomer here. And this procedure returns a customer. And the interesting part is that you can also use them in code. So for example, you can write code in this way. Get customer by name, by passing the name, it returns a customer. This piece of code returns a customer. Then I can call a method define the customer. So get total amount LCY is a method defined into the customer table. So you can directly call it in your code, because the return object of this procedure is a customer object. So exactly like a standard object in C# or other type of languages. You can also return other complex types, like for example, you can return a list of text. You can return a dictionary, for example. You can, for example, return objects like HTTP response message. You can return CoUnit. you can return query, you can return report. So you can have, you can return page, XML port. You cannot return a list of records. So if I unselect this, you can see that this throws an error. So you cannot return a list of record customer. So you can return a record customer, but not a list of record customer. So this is not supported. You can, you have now, in this is actually not documented, I think, but if you check, now you have also a new event in pages called with a quite strange name called on after lookup. And this event can be used for retrieving the values of a lookup field. It's different on the standard on lookup because now this returns the record ref of the variable. And for example, if I want, if I have a field like here, I have sent the customer card. I've modified the primary contact number, and this primary contact number is connected to the contact table. When the user click the contact, I want to retrieve this. You can retrieve this in this way. So using the record ref, you can use record ref set table, the name of your contact table, and then retrieve the values. So it's a new event added to pages, not actually well documented in my opinion. I don't think there's no documentation now available, but it's available on pages and you can use that if you want. Another important feature is related, as said before, to permission and permission set. So you can now directly in IL language, not more by using XML code, you can define a permission set. Permission set can be created by using a permission set object with the property assignable true, and where you list the permissions that you have on these objects. So all the tables where you have the particular permissions, you can define more than one, obviously, more than one permission set. As you can see here, I define one, I define the second permission set with only a table, and then I define a more complex permission set with a long set of tables that, for example, work on fixed assets. You can also extend the permission set. So you can also create a permission set extension. As you can, here, the error is because I'm extending an object that I declared on this same extension, so forgot the error. This is why I said forgot the error, but you can also extend the permission set. This is quite interesting. So if I have defined this permission set, I can also create a permission set extension that extends this permission set, and it adds new object to this permission set. You can now create entitlement. Entitlement means a particular type of declaration of what objects can you have, which object in Business Central a customer can use according to the license that he purchased. So you can create an object called entitlement with a name, with the type, and this lists the entitlements that you can have. And an object entitlements can contain more than one permission set. So this is the list of permission set that you should have, your entitlement have. And you can also create your own. So this, for example, this I created these entitlements that uses standard entitlements. And as you can see, it throws me an error saying that these entitlements cannot be created because permission set called basic and so on belongs to a different module, and you cannot use that from the on this module because this is my custom extension. But you can, on your custom extension, you can create your own. So you can create your own entitlement with type application, your ID, And by saying that if you have the entitlement call test, you have these permission sets. And this is the basic, the base of the, a future way of controlling permission of your extensions, because you can create more than one entitlements. And if, for example, I have a basic license, I have the rights to use the entitlement basic. If I had the full license, I had the rights to use the full entitlement. And in these ways, okay, I can control what I can do. I switch to projects, because the other features is related to the report extension. So you can now extend the report. As you can see here, for example, I extended the standard sales invoice report. In this extension, quite common request. I want to add a new field into the sales invoice header. So I created a table extension of the sales invoice header. I added this new field called additional notes. And on the sales invoice, my customer asked me to print this new field. Previously, you should, if you want only for adding a new field, you need to duplicate the reports, so create a new sales invoice report. Now you can create simply a report extension object that extends the standard sales invoice. And you can, in the dataset field, add a few new fields, exactly like you do in the pages. So you can, for example, do add, select the data item, the other data item, for example, control space gives you the list of the data item that you have on this report, and you can add your custom fields as column of this data item. This supports also global variables. So for example, here I have created a global variable called global text. And I added this global text into the request page. So you can also add fields into the request page. I have the global text variable into the request page where the user can type things, a text, for example, when execute the report. And I can use this global variable inside my data item. You can also add the data items to a report. So for example, in this case, I'm extending the sales invoice and I am adding a new data item to the other data item. For example, for the lines, I add a new data item to the header with that item link, and from this I can extract the fields that I want. So you can modify a lot of your existing report, add fields, add data item, add global variables, handle events, and so on. And obviously, as said before, the layout is not touched. So you can extend the data item, but you cannot extend the layout. Layout is totally outside. So this works exactly like standard report. So you have a new layout here. The new layout inherits all from the all fields from the base reports, plus all the new things that you have added into the report extension object. So this is to quickly describe the report extension. Related to reports, another new features related to reports and mainly related to Business Central 18 is a support of native support for barcodes. So Business Central 18 now supports natively the users of barcodes. Microsoft has subscribed an agreement with a barcode provider called ID Automation for having a set of standard barcode fonts automatically installed and provisioned on a SaaS tenant. So when you activate a SaaS tenant or update a SaaS tenant to Business Central 18, automatically you have this font installed on your environment. And simply on your report, you can create a barcode and handle this natively. You have some, the base application now has the possibility to handle barcodes very easily. To do that, you can simply, in this example, I created a very simple label for an item. So a new report that works on the item table. And as you can see here, I extracted three fields, number, description, and a barcode field where with a text. In the Onaster get record trigger, I'm creating a barcode. And creating a barcode, you can now use that by using new objects that are available on Business Central 18. That simply are the interface barcode form provider and the new enum called barcode symbology. To handle a barcode, you can simply create, define the barcode form provider by using the interface. And as default, the barcode form provider now is only one, and is ID automation. But you can also create your own custom barcode form provider, simply creating, implement this interface, create your own, extend this enum, add your own implementation, and then you can your barcode form provider totally handled by your own. As default, Business Center now supports only this ID automation barcode form provider. So you set this barcode form provider. In the barcode symbology enum, you set what type of barcode you want to use. And as you can see here, the type of barcode are quite a lot. You can select what type of barcode you want to use. You can, here I created my barcode string by placing simply the number, but you can do what you want. You can validate if you want the barcode string by calling the validate input of the barcode form provider interface. This is a method that simply checks if the string that you have want to print into the barcode fields is supported by this type of barcode. If it's supported, you can go away. If it's not supported, an error is shown to you saying that your string contains characters that are not supported by the selected type of barcode. And then if it's okay, you can code the encode font method of the barcode form provider interface by passing the string that you want to place and the type of barcode. And this creates an encoded string that you can place on your report. And this encoded string, when you define the layout of the report, you can, when you define the layout, specify what font, what online font should use. The online font can be simply called by name. So you don't necessarily need to install the font on your local machine. You can do that. But you can also not do that and simply checking the name of the online font is documented into the Business Center docs page and placing, saying that this field into the layout is printed with that. So for example, if I open this quickly, I have my, you can, this is my very quick layout of the barcode, of the this barcode record. If Word opens, okay, you can, or have in the font installed, and so, and then you can select the font. Otherwise, if you don't want to have the font installed, simply fill here the name of the font that you want to use, and this font are documented online. And then your field, when your report, when you will be displayed online, will automatically render because the fonts are now automatically supported and installed on the service tier in the online platform. So I think that one of the most requested features for reporting is now actually supported. And also totally extendable, so you can, you are not forced to use that this barcode provider, but you can use absolutely your own. Last features available for development now: the extension validation on upgrade is improved, so a new per tenant extension validation service is available. And when you create, when you upload a per tenant extension, now a lot more validation are performed. this particular understanding is validated on different aspects. For example, all dependencies are checked and the system checks all dependencies have been provided. Code should compile both up and down. So no breaking changes and so on. No breaking schema changes and no breaking code changes. So symbols, dependencies, all are fixed. No duplicate IDs. So all is checked into your complete tenant. So complete your, when you upload the pertinent extension, all a complete check of this pertinent extension availability and validity is performed. And another important last topic, another important aspect of new features available on Business Central in Team is related to the Power Platform. When you use Business Central connectors, now the standard Business Central connectors has a new version of triggers available. So for example, for flows, if you select the Business Central connector, now you have a lot of triggers listed as V3, so while previously was listed as V2. This means that these are new, with new parameters and new features supported. The most important part, in my opinion, one of the top requested features now is available. So the possibility to use, select the API category on the standard connector. Previously, if you want to use, for example, a custom entity, or if you want to expose a custom API to Power Apps or to Flow or Power Automate or also for Power BI, you need to create a custom connector. That means that you need to create this custom connector and then use this custom connector from Power Apps or Power Automate. Now, instead, the standard connectors permits you to specify also the API categories. So when you click here, you can see that you have standard APIs, but also the list of your custom endpoint, custom APIs. So you can select the custom APIs that you have exposed. So no more needs to create custom connectors if you want to expose custom fields or if you want to expose custom entities to Power Apps, to Power Automate, or in general with the Power Platform. Extremely powerful feature. So this is the complete overview of what you have new in Business Central 18 now. Obviously, sorry if we was quite quick. I hope to have given you the an overview of the possibilities. I remember that next week, Microsoft have pre-recorded an official event, an official launch event for Business Central 18, where with the different sessions where you can go, where you can see all what I show today, much more in details, obviously. Because a different session and not only 1 hour and a half session. Start working with Business Central 18. Please remember that Business Central 18 is actually available on premise. Roll up on the online tenant is in progress. Online tenant will be started from tomorrow. The upgrade of the online tenant is planned starting from tomorrow, but it depends on the region, Europe region. I think it will be the next week. Please remember also the important message is that if your customer is not ready for Business Central 18, now you have 60 days to stop the upgrade. So you can postpone the upgrade of 60 days. So if your customer is not ready or if you don't want the upgrade, please use these features into from the admin center and postpone the upgrade. Okay, I finish my presentation.
Thank you very much, Stefano. Now it's time to start our Q&A session. And I see that we have already received the questions. Do you see, Stefano, questions?
Yes.
I think that we can start discussion and answering to the questions. If you have any additional questions, just drop them into Q&A section.
Okay, I try to answer some of them. Question about barcodes. Does this mean we can now print barcodes on postal sales invoice layout? Absolutely yes. Barcodes means that you can now handle barcodes natively, so without installing nothing or without calling external services, but you can use them on all the records you want simply by calling the barcode form provider interface and the type of barcode that you want to support. All barcode forms are installed as default into the online tenant, so you don't have to modify nothing about that. So all is natively supported. Can you add a new field to the record layout with extension, or do you need to duplicate the layout? No, to the record layout, you need to create your own layout. Your report extension is related to the data set of the report. So when you create a report extension, it extends the data set. You inherit all what is defined into the report object itself, but not the layout. The layout, RDL file or Word file, is something different that must be created by your own. So this means that or you have your own layout, or you should start from the standard layout. But the important thing is that now you don't duplicate the complete report. So the problem in the past is that to add a field into the sales invoice, the custom field, you need to duplicate the sales invoice. This means that when you duplicate the code of the sales invoice report, you are not aligned with Microsoft reports. If Microsoft changes something in the standard report, you don't have these modifications. Now with the report extension, you simply add a new field, one line of code, into the report extension, and then you have that. But the layout is something different. There is no preview posting action to be found on payment reconciliation journal. This is quite strange, because this version as you posted in this is correct in the same version as you have online. I not checked the on-premise version, honestly. You should have this, or maybe you can try to customize the page. Maybe it's not automatically visible. I not checked the only, honestly, the on-premise version, but you should have this. Is it possible to authorize the app without user interface to get data from BC18 using API page? I not understood the question, honestly. Authorize the app without user interface to get data. Maybe you means authorization. So an external app that needs to connect to Business Central by using OAuth authentication. If this is the questions, the response is no. Actually, OAuth authentication is the recommended way, but not, is basic authentication will be deprecated, but actually is totally available. Unfortunately, at the moment, Business Center does not support connecting from external app to API pages by using, for example, the service-to-service OAuth authentication methods, so silently, without user interface and so on. And this is something where Microsoft is working, but currently not supported. Can we also print QR barcode? No. I've asked a lot about this, but actually not. QR code are not supported. You can obviously, no means that Microsoft is not supporting officially QR code, but you can handle by yourself QR code. Obviously, but no, Microsoft does not support actually QR codes. When you do a report extension and compile the app, the RDL file is the same as the standard with the new fields? No. As said before, the report extension does not work on the layout. So when you create a report extension, you have a data set that contains all the standard fields, all the standard business logic and so on, but the RDL file created is a totally empty file. You need to create your own layout or duplicate the standard layout. Layout is something different, something out of Business Central. Do you have an idea if invoicing will be added in the future updates? If so, do you have an idea when this is planned? Invoicing, I don't know what you mean, but electronic invoicing is supported on different, certain countries. So there are some countries where invoicing is supporting. I don't think that in all countries use invoicing, or I don't know honestly if all countries has invoicing support in Business Central, but for sure there are some customers where invoicing is supported. The job queue for cost adjustment is a predefined one or has to already been creating a schedule? It has to be creating a schedule, if I remember. It's not the that's not the predefined. You should create a job queue and... do you know what's the new limit for database export? It was mentioned that it's increased, but Microsoft Docs and the clear answer about the limit. No, I don't know this, because I know that there was some work on this topic. I think that something will be announced in the administration session next week. I know that the limits are increased, and the new service is totally revisited. So the new export service was totally revisited, and but I don't know actually how is the limit of size to create a database export, if there's a limit on size. For sure it's increased.
I think that we have already answered all the questions. So thank you very much, Stefano, once more for a really interesting webinar on the new version, and just short information for all the participants that recording and slides will be sent by email. Thank you and see you during our next webinars. So, and bye Stefano. So thank you.
Thank you to all the attendees, and bye-bye.
Bye-bye.